Hello everybody, today I played some Outbreak and I decided to record my game and show everyone how it's done. I chose Doc with the shotgun and the revolver. I could have chose the P9, but the revolver with the higher damage allows me to deal with Apexes easier. So our teammate chooses Glass, I'm fine with that, and Smoke. So I'm here thinking, alright, we have a pretty good comp, we have Glass to hold down a point, we have Smoke for Macintosh, and this is where I went all wrong. Now I see he has a second opinion, but he sticks with Glass. Now when I saw Smoke's unaccessorized SMG, I went to check their level, and here I got a little bit salty, but I'm fine. So Sierra Veteran Wing, I would say this one's the hardest. I did the Epidemic missions, but I found that just Sierra Veteran Wing is hard. In the Protect Jaeger, it's very easy to just use Jaeger as a body shield and then pick him up whenever he's down. So here I pull out my Magnum and I just start sniping these boys. And run in. Now notice here that these things actually grow when you hit them. I walk into this room, I kill one. I blow up one and I kill the other one. Now one of these flanks behind me, I miss the first shot and I hit him with the second one. I take the shortcut over here and I check where my teammates are. I run into the objective room and I just see a bunch of these zombies. Now usually I rarely see spawns there. I get hit once, but that's fine. I run in here. I check for hostiles. This Glass doesn't notice. Right now in the voice chat, I told him not yet because we haven't finished barricading. So I decided to just, what the hell. I walk out here, I grab the shotgun, and I just start hamming away. Now that was a really bad situation for me right there. I have 9 health, so immediately I go for the health pack. Because I have no idea where the nearest gadget box is, so I didn't want to waste a stim shot this early. Now right there, I actually accidentally got a headshot off. And I wasn't sure what killed it so fast, but I realized shotguns, mini pellets, headshots, yeah. Now right there, it hits me with the barrel. It's behind me. He tried to kick me. I pop another one in his head. Body. I come over here. I decide to be a jerk and do that. Now I pull out my stim pistol. The first one I shoot is on Smoke, but you know, he's a jerk and he decided to move. So I heal myself, I grab the extra supplies, and I open the door because I wanted to use my overheal so that I can get the maximum benefit out of it. I run out, I see one of those boys, and I just start hacking away. Now right here, I ran out of ammo, and I didn't want to pull out my pistol, so I just used the takedown. Now I check my kill to make sure that they aren't smurfing. Pop. Hit. Pop. I see the gadget box. At that time, I just started rushing in because I saw the gadget box, and I wasn't afraid. Now we get to Macintosh. I was bored and I knew the Smasher would come out. I run in, I pop one in the head. I didn't finish the job, so I saw him, I had to pop another one. Now here I had a bigger leg spike, but it was fine. I run up, pop. Pop. Now, when we were securing, I specifically told them not to just secure her immediately. I actually forgot where the barricades were. Now, some key walls to barricade. This wall. The other. That wall you have to barricade unless your glass, dock, whatever you have is going to hold that entire doorway. I close this door to prevent any flanks. I come back, grab my ammo again. And I feel like we're ready, so I just revive Macintosh. And I go to my little balcony. Now here is pretty much self-explanatory. Sadly, I did not manage to get the videos or the audio because my computer is basically a PC plugged into a potato. Now the key thing to using shock to pulling dock, run impact grenades. If you're doing the Jaeger one, smoke grenades is optional. Now I notice the barricades and I look back, but I realize I have about 20 of these things charging at me. Now I didn't know I was gonna get flanked there because I forgot that my teammates were, well, just low leveled and not very aware of what's going on. Now I see the glasses. I see glasses down. I drop out of my station. I run over to pick them up. Now here I did take a considerable amount of damage, but I instantly impact grenaded to get myself out of there. Now, one of the problems with using the shotgun is that it has a very slow reload speed. It's basically reloading a tank with some sticks. Now here I get overwhelmed. I run away so I don't get kicked. I drop down this and. When you're reloading, you want to just run around. Now here, I actually did get kicked through the wall, in fact. Macintosh is secure, and the breacher in this level is actually very hard, painful to deal with. I wanted smoke to grab Macintosh, so because well he had, what I saw is he had an SMG, and if he is running around with it, that's gonna be very easy for us to, well, or for him to run around and still fight. And that's when I saw a problem. He's holding a pistol. That's smoke with a pistol. I didn't give two damns about it because. Well, you don't really need to since you can just drop Macintosh. I hit the van out of fun and the smashy comes out. Now, here's some key tips with dealing smashy. Don't do that and lose your attention. That could very much be fatal. So you wanted to get it to charge you. So shoot it once. So if you have a shotgun, shoot it once. And let him charge and watch as he charges you. Remember to move out the way because being charged is very painful. I hit him, I run. I couldn't get out the way in time, so I run away again and he hits me twice. And I did not expect that because he usually auto retargets to somebody else whenever he's hit somebody. I try to get him to charge me and well he does and I get stuck on a ledge. I come over here, I go for the takedown. I shoot him again. I get trapped next to the ambulance. And I go for the takedown. So I down him there. And we cleared the first area. The first area is the easier area because in the late area, you have to hold Macintosh while she's running. That is why I play Doc, so that I don't have to rely on my team to pick me up. Here I just stopped going for the Apex and I went for the Gadget Box because I need to be self-reliant and not get, well, attempted to be picked up. Thank you. I actually got really confused as to where to enter. I was actually surprised that they just went and started opening the door, so I decided to just hold this one door and let them get the other two. I saw the door opening, so I decided to finish off the zombie and go. But then I didn't notice that my teammate had just brought every zombie to me. I decided to forget everything and just go and close the door. Now I may have shut out Glass, but you know, he joins in after 5 seconds and he got a really cool takedown animation, so it's justified. First of all, I heal myself. Second ball, I tried to aim for Macintosh, but it just hit Smoke instead. Thank you. the reason I went through that window instead of just going the normal way is because from the window, it's easier to get to the staircase. And secondly, if you go through the normal way and you get to the helipad, you're going to be flanked by the zombies. Now, I tell them to go on ahead, and so here what I do is I hold down this entire door by myself. Well, I realized there were no more of them left. But then I realized my teammates were being overwhelmed, so I had to, you know, do something about it. They hit me, I just knocked them off the platform. I could have went for a takedown right there, but I decided not because it could be very risky. That's my least favorite bit. And there I completed the mission with 193 kills. They had just slightly more than me. Combined. Alright? That is what makes me sad. Now, of course, I start BMing. And I felt really happy because, you know, I carried. And that's the end of the videos. Or whatever this was, commentary, I don't know. Goodbye.